Automated data-driven systems increasingly make decisions that affect our lives. These systems often make use of machine learning and other artificial intelligence. And they make decisions like which advertisements or recommendations should be shown to which individuals. Does a set of medical images indicate that an individual has cancer? How likely is a criminal offender to commit a crime again? Yet these systems behave like black boxes. We do not know why certain decisions are being made. My research seeks to enable data-driven systems to be accountable for their decisions.
We also use machine learning technology to build tools. You might think of these tools as automated privacy assistants that learn a person's privacy preferences and then help the person automatically implement these preferences, for example, by setting cookie preferences in a web browser or for helping configure a corporate firewall policy.
I work on discovering ways to understand energy consumption in buildings by using sensing and machine learning. So my group is working on looking at ways in which you can disaggregate the total consumption of a building, total electricity consumption, into individual appliances and give you at the end of the day something that says, okay, so in refrigeration you spent this much, in cooling and heating your house you spent this much, lighting this much. And that is a better standing point for you to make decisions.
So what we're trying to do is use machine learning methods that we can build from these quantum chemical simulations that will allow us to run much faster calculations on bigger systems to model more complex materials for longer times so that we can design better materials for engineering applications.
We've developed a computer vision and machine learning based system that allows us to look at images of microstructures, which are the fundamental data of the materials scientist. We now are proceeding to use that system in a variety of ways that impact engineering, that impact science, that impact industry, that impact the publishing world, and put these together in a way that hasn't been done before.
What we do here in the lab is work on biometrics identification. And biometrics is ways that we can identify who you are based on physical or behavioral characteristics. So for example, fingerprint, face, iris, those are all biometrics that can be used to identify who you are without you having to enter a password. So there's a negative stigma that Hollywood has imposed on biometrics. What we're trying to do here is make biometric identification a pleasant experience that is effortless.
I'm developing new computational technologies that will enable ordinary people to generate 3D models using natural, simple-to-use interaction techniques. Lots of people generate new 3D content and share it with the rest of the world through the internet. Using such data, we're developing new CAD tools where the end user controls the shape using very intuitive semantic attributes rather than using complex geometric operators. The computer now automatically learns what it means to make a car less muscular and a shoe more comfortable and makes the appropriate adjustments accordingly. The outcome of our work will have significant impacts on industrial product development, design creativity, and engineering innovation.
What we'll see in the future is computers that have been trained to solve engineering problems that are very complex, and that will relieve us of having to do that by hand ourselves. So in our view, these are not things that would be used to replace scientists and engineers, but augment them and make them much more powerful than they were in the beginning. So I think we're seeing a totally new age of science and engineering where machine learning and computing is able to augment our intellectual abilities much in the same way the steam engine augmented our mechanical abilities at the beginning of the century. That led to a huge industrial revolution, and today we have computing and machine learning that will lead to a huge intellectual revolution in science and engineering.